Just want to take a moment to thank all the veterans out there, those who are still with us and those who have passed on to glory. I want to thank my grandfather, L.D. Perrin. I want to thank my grandfather, Thomas Mirren Hunt. I want to thank my stepfather, Charles Frederick Weymouth III. I want to thank those who are with us today. I want to thank Dylan Belcher. He's a good friend of my, one of my best friends that's passed on. He's serving our country down in Texas. He's doing an outstanding job. Very proud of him. Also, I want to thank a guy I work with, Zach West. And also, very important, I want to thank my father-in-law, Gary Dow, who served as a United States Marine Corps. So I want to thank him for that as well. And all those friends out there that I have that have served God and country, I really do appreciate that. We do appreciate that. You know, the Bible says in John 3:16, and I'm paraphrasing, but it says, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Whosoever should believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And, you know, Jesus says no greater friend is one that he would lay himself down for, you know, his fellow man. And that's what these veterans have chosen to do. They have chosen to go and fight in another country far away from their loved ones and live their life as a sacrifice and give their life as a sacrifice so that we can have our freedom. And men of America, there's no better time than right now that we need to get off the couch and get up and get out and take a stand for all the silliness that's going on. We need to take a stand for Jesus Christ, and we need to take a stand for our country. We need men that are going to stand up and fight for what's right. We're going to fight for our families and fight for our freedom. We do not want all those veterans that have served us to have served us in vain and let that freedom pass away from us. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. If you don't know Jesus Christ today, I invite you to send a little message there and say, you know, Dan, I don't know him. Send us a message. Maybe we can give you a call and pray with you. I'd like to pray with you right now and just pray this message after me. Heavenly Father, you know, I'm a sinner and I have sinned. And I've not been a good man or a good woman. And, you know, I'm tired of being bad. I'm tired of being that way. But I heard that you sent your son, that he died on the cross, and that death payment was a payment for me to have everlasting life. If I choose to believe, if I choose to have faith, Lord, I'm choosing to have faith right now. Lord, come to me, live in me, give me a new heart, wash me with the blood of Jesus Christ. Help me to be a new person. Lead me, guide me, lead people to me from you that would help show me the way. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. If you prayed that prayer today, please leave us a little message down there or shoot us an email. We really appreciate you. We love you. We love our country, and we love the Lord Jesus Christ. What's the next song we're going to do, girls?
This next song is called Blood Bought My Freedom.
Land of the free, sweet home of liberty, you came at such a great cause. Our soldiers brave and true gave their lives for me and you. Someone died that you might be free. Blood bought my freedom. Someone had to die. Someone freely took my place. Blood was the price for supreme sacrifice. Someone died that we might be free. Over the sea, on an old rocky tree, a battle was fought for you and me. Now it won't be fought again, cause we have victory over sin. Thank God for Calvary, because his blood bought my freedom. Someone had to die. Someone freely took my place. Blood was a price supreme sacrifice. Someone died that we might be free. Let fall for freedom. Someone had to die. Someone freely took my place. Blood was a price for supreme sacrifice. Someone died that we might be free. Blood was the price for supreme sacrifice. Someone died that we might be free. Yes, Jesus died that we might be free.